So in this lecture now, we're going to talk about the third of three standard or reference electrodes that are used in potentiometry. And that is the calomel or the saturated calomel electrode. And then towards the end, we'll talk about all three reference electrodes that we've discussed thus far and put them in context with a reference scale to discuss relative potentials. So, the compound referred to as calomel is mercurous chloride, where we have two mercury atoms and two chloride atoms. And this compound is very insoluble in water, just like silver chloride was. So if mercury is to accept electron density and become reduced in the elemental form, mercury is a liquid upon reduction. And this frees up two chloride ions in solution. So to explain the redox process here, we can assign oxidation states, and each mercury atom is plus one when bound to chloride, which is negative one. And chloride is inert to the redox process, or it remains in the negative one oxidation state. However, mercury, each atom of mercury goes from plus one to zero, or each one accepts one electron. So there's two electrons total for two atoms of mercury. So this is the reduction half reaction for calomel. And it's said to have a standard reduction potential of 0.268 volts. Now, like we said previously with the silver-silver chloride electrode, we want this half reaction to be the fixed half reaction, where it has a fixed potential. And we do that by saturating it with potassium chloride, or by fixing the chloride concentration. So if it becomes saturated with potassium chloride, instead of having variable chloride concentration, then the potential changes to be a bit less favorable, or a smaller E value of 0.241 volts. And that's the value we're going to use in most calculations. So once again, I'll show how we can use this reference or standard as the anode in a voltaic type cell where oxidation occurs. And if this is going to be the anode half reaction, then I'm going to take this and flip it or write it as an oxidation where two chloride ions in the aqueous phase react with elemental mercury. And there's a mistake here. There should be two out front of mercury. And that gives calomel, which is a solid paste. And it also frees up two free electrons. So this anode reaction is occurring in one half cell. And of course, we connect that anode with a wire to the cathode half reaction, where reduction occurs. So let's use the same example of an indicator, just like we did in the last two videos, where we have copper two in the aqueous phase that accepts two electrons to become copper solid, the metallic form. So there are copper ions in solution that are reacting with two electrons to become reduced to form this copper solid electrode. And that occurs at the surface of this electrode. And we said in a previous video that this has a standard reduction potential of 0.34 volts relative to the standard hydrogen electrode. So in the anodic solution, we have chloride as an aqueous ion. However, neither mercury nor calomel are soluble in aqueous solution. So this electrode here is going to have a buildup of mercury, calomel, and some potassium chloride, all as sort of a paste, analogous to the silver chloride paste that was building up on the silver wire in the silver chloride electrode. So once again, we want this reference or standard electrode to have a fixed potential so that we can use that as the standard and tell something about the variable potential relative to the cathodic solution. So for this to have a fixed composition and fixed potential, then we need to have a constant concentration of chloride in solution. And the way we do that, once again, just like the silver chloride case, is where we add excess potassium chloride to the solution to the point where it precipitates out and sits at the bottom as a solid. And that potassium chloride, it's going to give you a fixed concentration of chloride, right? We have excess chloride source. And as chloride is consumed as a reactant of this oxidation for mercury, then chloride will enter the solution as potassium chloride dissociates from that solid form. So, of course, the indicator solution has variable concentrations, or it has an unknown concentration of copper analyte. And we can determine that concentration if the cell potential is known. So once again, we can calculate the standard potential, E naught, as being the potential of the cathode, which is copper, 0.34 volts, minus the potential of the anode, and that standard potential, if it's saturated with excess potassium chloride, is 0.241 volts. So I subtract cathode minus anode, and this is going to give E standard as 0.099 volts. So let's say that our voltammeter or potentiometer is going to read an actual value of 0.102 volts. We can relate that non-standard potential to the standard potential to tell something about the unknown concentration of copper at the cathodic solution. So you can use the Nernst equation to determine unknown concentration. So the non-standard potential is equal to the standard potential minus 0.0592, all divided by 2 moles of electrons, right? We lose 2 moles of electrons during the oxidation of 2 moles of mercury zero, and we gain 2 moles of electrons during the reduction of copper two, multiplied by log of Q. Now, the Q equation for this reaction is products of a reactants once again, but we're going to neglect copper, that's a solid, and we'll neglect calomel, that's also a solid, and we neglect mercury, which is a liquid. So the only concentrations that will appear are copper two, which is a reactant, so that's on the denominator, and that's multiplied by the chloride concentration squared. And that chloride concentration is fixed by the excess chloride in solution by saturating it with potassium chloride. So what you can then do is find this unknown copper given the known voltage, the standard voltage, and their relationship in the Nernst equation. Now, of course, as the redox process occurs, electrons are a product of the oxidation of mercury, and those travel through the wire, which is a conductor, from the anode towards the cathode. And when the electrons reach the surface of this copper metal, then the copper two binds, reacts with two electrons, and forms copper solid. And so you get a negative charge buildup where the electrons are entering the cathode, and a positive charge buildup where the electrons are exiting the anode. And because of that charge buildup, we must connect these with some sort of salt bridge to maintain electron neutrality, where you have an anion component in the salt bridge that will migrate towards the anode, and the cation component will migrate towards the cathode. So once again, we use potassium nitrate and some other really soluble salts that are inert towards redox or will not undergo reduction nor oxidation, and they're highly, highly soluble in water. So you could be asked once again to write the shorthand for this cell. So I'll write it up here where we have some space. So this is the shorthand notation where we have mercury liquid, and there's a phase barrier with calomel, which is a solid. And then we also have a phase barrier with chloride in solution, is fixed by the potassium chloride. And then that aqueous solution is connected through a salt bridge, which we indicate with this double vertical line. And that's connected to the cathodic solution where there's copper two. And because this concentration of chloride was fixed, then the unknown potential, or the potential that is known and measured by the voltammeter, can be used to find the unknown concentration of copper in the cathodic solution. And finally, that copper two is in solution, but copper zero is the solid electrode here and an insoluble, and therefore there's a phase barrier to copper solid. So that would be your shorthand notation. So finally, I want to now talk about the three reference electrodes and their relative potentials. And what I've constructed here is a reference scale. So first we did the standard hydrogen electrode, which is said to have a potential of 0.00 volts. And we've been talking about the indicator, or the unknown solution, as being this copper two, which has a reduction potential reported as 0.34 volts relative to the standard hydrogen electrode. But now we've learned more about other reference electrodes, namely the silver-silver chloride, which had a potential of 0.197 volts when saturated with excess chloride. And then we've learned one more, which is the calomel, or the mercury and then mercurous chloride electrode. Also, when saturated, that produces a more positive potential relative to the other two of 0.214 volts. So if you're asked to find the potential of some compound, its reduction potential relative to other references that are not the standard hydrogen electrode, right? Then we can simply look at the difference on this reference scale. So relative to the silver-silver chloride, it's going to have a potential of 0.34 minus 0.197. So we simply subtract that difference to find the relative potential, 0.143 volts. And if you wanted to find the potential between copper and the calomel electrode, then you would subtract 0.34 and 0.241 to find 0.009 or 099 as the relative potential there. Now, you have to be careful about this number line. So let's say that we had another substance, some unknown metal 2 with reduction potential of negative 0.51 volts relative to the standard hydrogen electrode. Then you could find the difference relative to the silver-silver chloride by adding an extra 0.197, but we have to be careful with the sign here. So if you want to go from the standard hydrogen to the silver silver chloride, then this difference or potential would be negative 0.15 volts, and then it's another 0.197 away in the negative direction, so minus 0.197 volts. So that's negative 0.707 volts relative to the silver silver chloride. And then if you had it relative to calomel, it's going to be an even larger value. So here the potential would be the negative 0.51 volts relative to the standard hydrogen electrode minus negative 0.241 volts relative to the saturated calomel electrode. Okay. So you want to be able to draw this reference scale, know these three values for the standard electrodes, and then convert the relative potentials from standard hydrogen to silver silver chloride and calomel based on values that are given in a table. And all the values reported in the table are relative to the standard hydrogen electrode. So for more practice with reference scales and the calomel electrode, and electrochemistry in general, you can visit Unit 4 of my analytical course guide, that is the electrochemistry portion, and that's available at chemguides.com.